Coming up next on ATETV, wind energy technology.
The growth of wind power is just phenomenal. The industry is growing so rapidly that the expertise that we're reaching out for is very difficult to find.
Architectural technology.
Everything now is becoming green, so I'm continuing my education and furthering my knowledge and going into a field that's up and coming.
And internships.
Internships, co-ops are excellent opportunities to get OJT, on-the-job training.
Now on ATETV. From across the country to your own backyard, ATETV shows you the many advanced technological education opportunities available at your local community college. Looking for a true hands-on career in green technology? How about becoming a wind energy technician? A typical day on the job could involve resolving electrical, mechanical, and hydraulic malfunctions all at over 200 feet up in the air. Take a look.
My name is Mark Illos. I work for an Exco Service Corporation. I am operations manager for two wind power plants here in northeast Colorado. The growth of wind power is just phenomenal. The industry is growing so rapidly that the manpower, the knowledge, the expertise that we're reaching out for is very difficult to find.
So not only would you check the gear teeth on the ring itself, but you'd also want to make sure that you took a look at as many, on the driver.
As a technician, you're not going to just be greasing and just checking and cleaning systems. You're going to be troubleshooting, repairing, a lot of mechanical aspects of it. It's not just standing at a table, nice controlled environment, removing a broken bolt. In many cases, as a wind turbine technician, you're going to kind of be in a pretzel sort of position, maybe upside down, sideways. You may be sitting out on the ledge of the turbine outside on the hub or something to that effect, over 200 feet in the air with the wind blowing and maybe a little bit of snow. Technicians should feel good about their chances in the job market as the exponential growth of this industry continues in the next few years. The demand for technicians, qualified technicians, is going to get higher and higher and higher. And they're getting harder and harder to find. So if those individuals get started now, the sky's the limit.
Now there's a job that's exciting and secure. In fact, if the U.S. increased its wind energy supply, the demand for jobs would soar. If you want to learn more about wind energy technology, be sure to visit your local community college. Speaking of green, architectural technology and green building are tied into green jobs. Let's meet Christina, a student in the architectural technology program at Sinclair Community College.
Increases the building depressurization should also increase.
My name is Christina Solenberger. I'm going to Sinclair Community College and I'm in the Architectural Technologies program.
You want to push mode twice.
Everything now is becoming green, so I'm continuing my education and furthering my knowledge and going into a field that's up and coming.
So you're going to learn to use three different types of software.
We serve the less served population, and that includes minorities, that includes women. We want them in this program.
You'll see under the energy analysis.
They help you with your tuition, so I decided this would be a good idea for a start towards my education.
Take a baseline building pressure.
We're performing blower door tests here in the lab, so we know how to do it for our own energy audits. If you do an energy analysis on anything, you can learn the money you could be saving and the energy you could be saving. There's a lot to learn and a lot that people really don't know yet, so new jobs are going to start coming. I plan to transfer to a four-year college and finish the architecture program and hopefully become a licensed architect in several years.
Community colleges are an affordable and accessible path to higher education and to the job market. And graduates of that program can enter the workforce and directly impact the economy by helping new and existing homes become more energy efficient. Community colleges have strong relationships with business and industry, which provide not only hands-on learning opportunities, but actual on-the-job experience through internships and co-ops. Let's take a look at the internship programs happening at Wake Technical Community College.
Community colleges are all about preparing folks for the workforce. That is our primary mission, workforce development. So we work very closely with industry representatives, advisory committees, and they really drive what we train individuals on. So when students are finished with us, they're ready to enter the workforce because we have designed that program based upon what they have told us to do.
In addition, those companies have employed students as interns working on specialty projects, and they have participated in our video gaming expo as well as in the job fairs that are available to them.
Internships, co-ops are excellent opportunities to get OJT, on-the-job training. We're mostly academics, we're practitioners. But to get out there and to get your hands in and work with people that are actually doing what you're being trained to do, that's simply, you can't replace that type of an experience. It's fundamentally key to being successful.
Well, see, well, you just got to drag the elbow down there and then just tilt the
head. I've worked on two internships now, and that first project we were working to build a trainer to do pill pressing in manufacturing. So what we essentially did is create a room and all of the hardware that a technician would normally have to use to do their job, and created a full simulation to where somebody can sit down at the computer and do their day-to-day job, you know, adjusting pill specifications and also encountering the normal problems that they would encounter as they are doing their job in the real life scenario.
Those students are getting real life career training and get to see the results of their work by the time they graduate from college. So that's a win-win for the industry and a win-win for the students.
And congratulations, you finished the first part of the safety audit.
Internships and co-ops provide experience that is invaluable in preparing students for the workforce and for their future careers. If you want to learn more about internship programs at a community college near you, or want more information on anything you've seen today, explore our website at ATETV.org. Thanks for watching.